How far is it to New Zealand? All right. Talk to the self. How far is it to New Zealand, Corporal? I don't know, Corporal. Corporal doesn't know how far it is to New Zealand.
Didn't they tell you at school?
The only thing I remember of telling me at school was never to do that again to Rosemary Hodgkins. Centipede down her blouse.
And that's your idea of time well spent, is it?
There's not much to put in a centipede down a girl's blouse. But seeing as how I was the only one who dare handle it, I had the fun of getting it out.
Think, would you, that from such small beginnings would come this interest in New Zealand?
He's been consistently disgusting all his life.
We're just a growing lad's curiosity about the wonders of life.
Interested in centipedes, were you?
What a pleasant day. I wonder how many people realize that in conditions as good as this, a well-trained sniper could pot him from almost a mile away.
That I'm not a centipede. I'm busy having an accident and discovering you've got a broken leg.
Fields are going to New Zealand for Christmas.
You don't have to go as far as that for it. It creeps up on you wherever you are.
I'm going to be prepared for it this time. I hate people who leave things to the last minute.
That's what our Nelly was over telling her husband. Didn't make any difference. They still had all them children.
Christmas rush.
He's a great long probe, isn't he? How can a bloke think about Christmas this time of the year?
Well, you're not going to believe this, but watch where you're treading, because I think there have been some reindeer around.
What are we doing in here on a nice summer's day?
It'll all become clear to you in a minute. Now just sit down and wait patiently. Good luck. The doctor knows well enough practice in doctor's surgery.
For what?
You have.
Oh, then we're only when overworking.
Working? You? The fastest sick note in the West?
See, I've got this back.
The worst case of terminal sick note in medical history.
I haven't had that many notes.
Only because I got fed up initially with the season ticket.
I had six specialists at my back.
So that's the explanation.
For what?
For those six holes in your shirt.
It's a while since I've used this.
My very words to Nora Batty the other day. I was showing her my little whistle.
Keep it quiet.
It is quiet. It's a silent whistle.
You've no idea how pleased I am about that.
It's a poacher's whistle for calling your ferrets in the dark.
Really? What do you call ferrets in the dark?
Come here, you bloody...
Just talk some claptrap. It's not a ferret whistle. Those whistles you can't hear are dog whistles.
Mine is a ferret's whistle.
Well, what's the difference?
Have you ever tried getting a Labrador down a rabbit hole?
Would you mind drawing the curtains, please?
I hate drawing my curtains during the daytime. Suppose the neighbours start sending flowers.
What are you going to show us any room?
You see.
Oh, you're not going to show us them holiday stamps again, are you?
No, I'm not going to show you those holiday stamps. What's the matter with my holiday stamps? Come on, we'll sit down. It's been your age. It's nobody to come on. As a matter of fact, you've never seen these before. Well, I'm showing you these with a very serious purpose. I want to remind you of last Christmas and what a disaster it was. And why? Because some idiot who shall be nameless had this great idea about not shopping early for Christmas. Some idiot had this theory about waiting till the last minute on Christmas Eve and snapping up all the bargains.
What is that?
That is last year's Christmas tree.
That looks like a bit of old prick.
It is a bit of old prick. You want to find this idea? What about waiting till Christmas Eve to do our shopping?
All right, I did.
All the fun of the Yuletide rush, you said.
The ruddy cheeks and the choppers.
The ruddy cheeks of the shoppers. You know, like it was when we was kids.
All jostling happily together on Christmas Eve.
Which last year fell on a Sunday.
When all the shops were shut.
Boom. Now this was our Christmas dinner.
Very funny.
Oh, how we laughed. A fish finger and a chip we laughed.
I wonder what they're doing in the word house, we said.
And I wished I was doing it with them. A right merry Christmas it was. Well, it's not going to happen again this year. As my old scoutmaster used to say, we are going to be prepared. So on your feet, you men. Come on. We are going to do our Christmas shopping.
Christmas shopping? Christmas shopping?
Yep. Come on.
Oh, no. Christmas shopping?
What are you doing? 4 o'clock.
Well,
I don't like these places.
What's wrong with these places?
They make your life go too fast. Look at these. Congratulations on a happy event. Then a few birthdays, wedding, happy anniversary, and wallop, you're in to get well soon.
No, you don't want to let cards make you nervous. Well, you've had as many cards as I've had.
Oh, yeah? Fan mail now, is it? Ever since you became Miss Bettinshop 1945.
Hey, happy condolences.
Who sends cards to you?
The electric gas board.
Oh, see, they're putting you off by postcard now, are they?
I'll collect final warnings.
Oh, come, you must have a nice little corner in that market.
Years ago, long before you perfected that visa, all communications from the gas board of a threatening nature.
Don't tell us, let me guess. Liberace.
Fuck off, Liberace. I'm doing a threatening nature. A big Emmy from the gas board. Did you see that? Did you see the way she looked at me? Her eyes were locked. Something electric passed between us.
You'll be cutting that off next minute. Now, what were you saying?
Oh, I forgot.
About communications from the gas board of a threatening nature.
Oh, that? Oh, yes, yes. Well, the letters used to come from some employee in an office, under managerial level. You know the type. Always has a rubber. Knows the price of his wife's hair lacquer. There's always one at the party trying to corner you into spelling things like illegitimate.
ILLEGITIMATE.
Have you got a rubber?
Oh, come on, get on. wrong with it?
No, I was just reflecting upon the impact of modernization on this individual here, who now gets his threatening letters from a computer.
That's true, I do.
And ignores them just the same as he always did. Isn't progress wonderful?
That's just what people need on a greeting card. Sticky fingerprints.
My name is Duncan Strophy. I knew the ma'am. She was a bit of a god. And she knew all about sticky fingerprints.
I'm sorry about the interruption. We'd just like to see your selection of Christmas cards.
Christmas cards? At this time of the year?
Ah, yes. Well, you see,
I... Mavis, pay no attention. He's not been the same since the accident.
Had an accident?
Don't press your luck.
Do you see the way his face
shrivels up, you know, when he gets angry? Here, get well soon.
Some days all you seem to get's comedians. Get well cards, Christmas cards. Oh, get out.
I assure you, madam, I'm being perfectly serious.
Get out.
Hey, Foggy, whilst you're at it, ask her if she's got a Valentine card for Nora Patty.
Preferably one with curlers.
The lot of you.
Experience?
You don't believe it? You try coming at me with a knife.
Oh, come on.
job, I...
Sit down! I haven't got a knife.
Use your teaspoon. Would it be all
right? Sidney, get him a knife.
He won't. Listen, I've seen him eat, and he's the last beggar that ought to have a knife.
I'm not having one of his blunt knives. Now, you don't really think that some fiendish foreign agent is going to come at him with a table knife, does he? No. I'll just nip out into the kitchen and get a proper knife.
Some people take everything so damn literally. Your knees playing up a bit again, you know. I hope it doesn't throw my timing out by that hell of that fracture. I wouldn't like to hurt you. I think you ought to warn him not to tangle with me. Do you think he's ready for a real knife?
See if you can disarm her from that tree.
I'll cure him of that urge he's got to sneak up on married women.
I'd rather not go into details.
Look, I can understand that.
No offence intended, no.
Or none taken.
But I mean, when you've spent a lifetime perfecting a technique of impressing yourself on married women, you don't want to give away all your secrets in a book.
Now that's good thinking.
You never know who may be listening.
Absolutely. And in the wrong hands, a technique like that could be devastating.
You never know where it might end.
Well, it usually ends with you getting covered with a tray.
But it's worth it. Because that's Ivy. Nora usually comes at me with a yard brush.
Well, it's a powerful technique you've perfected there.
It is, Norm. It is.
Hey, look at that.
What's he doing with that big bloke at the bar?
Trying to get his breath back.
It's not as if they knew each other.
Maybe his dreams come true at last. Maybe he's just been recruited for MI5.
Hey, it must be something serious if Foggy's got his purse out. Oh, look at that action, man. That's smooth.
I hope he finds a better place to keep his suicide pill. If it gets locked in there, it'll be quicker to die of athlete's foot.
Sugar? Oh, I didn't ought to really. Say when.
going down again, are you? I can't drink it without. I never use it myself.
And it shows, love. If you took a spoonful occasionally, you might find it might relax you. Keep your hands off your airing cupboard.
We need some new vests. They're only fit for dusters.
Yes, I will say that for them. Troublesome as men are, their old vests make lovely dusters.
If it won't shine with an old vest, it won't shine, I always say.
Mind you, your wool is so small, I'm surprised you got enough vest to do more than one window.
Oh, I've always bought them for him extra long.
I should think medium looks like extra long on your wool.
Small has its advantages. At least you have no trouble getting into every corner.
Which brings me to why I wanted to see you. Somebody else who has no trouble in getting in every corner. Your neighbour. Him down there with the clutching hands. Small and obnoxious.
You don't have to tell me about him. I've been dodging him for years.
He grabbed me in the kitchen this morning.
Came up behind you.
Yeah.
Quick feint with his left hand, then whoops it to you with his...
That's right.
Oh, I know his every move.
I nearly dropped the chip pan.
You should have. Down his trousers. The sooner it gets covered in batter, the safer it's going to be. The safer for every one of us round here.
But you see, it isn't everyone, is it? It's just you and me. See, that's why I thought we ought to have a talk. What are we going to do about him? It's getting so you need eyes in the back of your corsets. How are we going to stop him?
Well, I normally use my yard brush.
Say he catches you when you haven't got your yard brush with you.
Oh, I don't go far without my yard brush.
No, but say he catches you without it.
Then I hope he's washed his hands. Try not to think about his ferrets.
But it's time that he was stopped.
Oh, you don't have to convince me. That cheeky devil's been places that would never occur to my Wally, even if he was looking for one of his damn pigeons.
You know what we're doing wrong, don't you? We're too defensive. We start leaping about and shrieking when he grabs us. Well, that just encourages him. It's time we started fighting back.
Will you have a piece of cake? I think I will, love.
While we decide how we're going to handle him. With gloves, of course, being the first thing that springs to mind.
Hey, you! That's a lot of Christmas trees.
No, no, I've got 100.
It reminds me of Rosemary.
What does?
All these trees. If we hang about, we should see Nelson Eddy come riding out. West Mounted Police.
Hey, up, I saw that film. Nelson Eddy fell in love with this Indian bird.
If you'd seen nothing for days but trees, I think you'd fall in love with anything.
Well, are we going to walk down and look at my trees or what?
I think there were mountains falling in love all over the place.
Fine body of men. Used to love their horses.
Trappers, Eskimos, anything.
They always got their man.
There's a whole new wealth of poignancy on that.
Come in or not?
Not!
We'll stay here, Foggy, and wait for Nelson Eddy.
Where's that double you, man? Come on.
Looks like we volunteered again. They all look alike. How's they gonna know which are yours?
I have a map.
All we need now is a map. Which helps him find his way about his map.
I resent that slur on my military capabilities.
But you're not looking for Christmas trees, because I reckon it's going to take me until Christmas to find them.
I know what I'm doing. A map is as good as a picture to the trained military eye. We need to be over in that direction. 500 yards. These are my trees. I've a signed receipt. Oh, yes, these are my trees. Well, 100 of them anyway. Huge, aren't they? I told you this was the time to go shopping for Christmas bargains.
is he seeing this lot with fairy lights?
Gave 10 quid to in the pub, thinks it is Christmas.
I've been done. He saw it coming.
Rubbish. We've got a slip here.
We?
By virtue of our shrewd investment.
Our shrewd investment?
Certainly. You don't think I'm so selfish as to keep a good thing like this all to myself? For a mere £3.30 odd pence from each of you, entitles you to full partnership in this lucrative enterprise.
And we've only got to carry 33 1/5 each.
I cannot move in them from here.
I'm not surprised. You never get this lot into your purse.
It's frightened you off, hasn't it? Just so used to thinking small, your minds won't expand. But take in the opportunities we've come across here. They're not just trees. Try to think of them as pencils. Lollipop sticks. Toothpicks. My God, we can't corner the toothpick market. If you come back here, you'll dig out on a gold mine. You be sorry when I'm driving past in the Bentley. All right. They're my trees. Now listen. My God, they're crawling with insects. Get off. Well, the least you can do is help and keep the pest free.
Nothing you dismay.
I suppose you think that's funny.